at this special moment, I really like to, you know, mention about this because we call this Silicon Valley Entrepreneur Festival. When we say the festival, it's also a culture. It's not only competition, business, money making, it's also a culture. So we have a great entrepreneur from China, someone I really admire and respect. And her name is Chen Baijia, Rebecca Chen. You know, she's been an entrepreneur for more than 20 years. More than 20 years. But during her entrepreneurship, not only, you know, make her business successful, but she also have the idea to serve the people, to educate the entrepreneurs and their next generation, also help the community. That's why when I told her that I've been in the Rotary Club for more than 8 years, so he asked me, what do you do at the Rotary Club? I said, well, we serve the community. We fundraise for many of the projects, and each year we helped more than 200 organizations, not only in the United States, but also in Asia, in India, in Africa, and in China. So she said, oh, well, that sounds so great. How can I help? I said, well, you are super busy, so I don't know what you can help. She said, well, maybe I can donate some money. I said, well, that'd be great. So today, actually, she's going to donate $1,000 for our Cupertino Rotary Club. So let's, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mr. Rebecca Chen to the stage. Yeah, come on, to the middle.
There we go.
Yeah, we're going to receive this check together.
This is very exciting. This is a very exciting opportunity. Thank you for this contribution and the difference it's going to make in the lives of young people in our community. Thank you.
This is all about our festival. It's not only yourself to be successful, also want all the others to be successful and to live the good life together. And Miss Rebecca Chen has been committed her life many years on education for the next generation in China, especially the entrepreneurs, next generation. So she has many good comments. Each time I talk to her, I learn a lot from her. So we're going to give the rest of the time to her to share her experience and her passion regarding the education, especially for the next generation entrepreneurs.
Okay, I will be her translator and for this period of time. Thank you.
我期待我的演讲不要让你们睡着就好。I
expect my speech will not let you sleep.
因为中午实在太困了，对，我的时差也没倒过来。
Especially in the time of afternoon, yeah, everybody would like to sleep.
很多我们公司做企业的训练，我们会做上市公司的训练，那你一定会问我们训练他们什么？其实我们训练他们的是企业文化。
In the last 14 years, we give training to companies and adults, and even for the listed companies in China, in Asia. But everybody asks us, what exactly train, what is that?
对，你不需要问我说到底企业文化是什么，我只告诉你结果，就是经过我们训练的企业，它的业绩一定会增长，因为我们不是为我们所说的负责任。
Actually, for a company, we don't really express our value by what we're saying. We guarantee the outcome, the result of this company after getting our training. So what we're doing is about corporate culture, business culture.
失败的人他会从 我的需要的里面看到别人的责任，成功的人是从别人的需要的里面看到我的责任。And
the key things of business culture, the most importantly, is the responsibility. For the fair people, they always can see the responsibility of others for my fair. But for the responsible person, they usually see my responsibility on my fair.
因为一个肩负责任的人
Before a people get the competence, get the abilities, or before that, they usually, the first place, they really responsible. It's a responsible man. They take responsibilities before they get the abilities.
我们所服务的企业，我们一定会让它业绩增长，因为这是企业雇佣我们的要求。
The company we serve, we must make them more profitable or make them more, make more revenue than before. That's our responsibility.
于是我们一定要训练他的员工基于目标，基于责任去达到结果。
What we train to the companies, to their staffs, the staffs of their responsible, are they responsible? Are they really take the duties? Are they really make up their mind to serve this company? That's what we do.
于是老板付了，老板会出昂贵的训练的费用，老板会发工资给员工，然后请他吃，请他住，请他学习。
Therefore, the boss man of this company will pay for the fees of the training, pay for the food, pay for the restaurants and the hotels for the staff to take our training.
可是员工说 ，No, 我不会去的，因为我太忙了。
But finally, surprisingly, the staff said, No, I won't come because I'm too busy at my work. I need no more training.
可是不训练，如何增长业绩呢
？But without training, how can we raise the revenue? How can we be more profitable?
于是我们坐下来研究如何可以训练他们。
And then we sit down and discuss how can we really, really train the staff of the company.
我们是在一家上市公司，我们坐下来讨论，讨论的结果是什么？有谁可以猜到
？Once upon a time, we really discussed this topic at a listed company in China, and let's guess what is the outcome? What's the result of this discussion?
对，如何让员工可以心甘情愿的接受训练
？How can we make the staff really, really want to take the training after all?
对，结果我们讨论的结果就是，我们不能训练他们说要如何为老板工作、为企业冲业绩。那训练什么呢？训练他们，因为他们关心的，做老板的要关心员工的需求，员工才会关心企业的需求。那么我们发现，员工关心的常常是他的家、他的孩子、他的太太，因为如果他的孩子不学习了，那个高管就不工作了；如果太太在家里，我们广州话说一哭二闹三上吊，那个高管也没有办法工作了。
Yeah, this is a long translation, but I can make it shorter. It's like the outcome eventually come. We finally find out that if you want the staff to work for the company, to work for the boss man, to make more profit, to make more revenue, but at the end, it's none of them business. It does not really, really important at that level significant.For the staff, but the staff really care about is about their families, their kids. And one day, if my wife is getting divorced with me, or my kids are going to like quit studying, expelled from school, that really affect my work. I can't really work in my workplace.
于是呢，我们就会设计一套课程。这套课程是教育他们如何教育孩子。可是教育他们如何教育孩子的一些原理，必须是用企业管理的原理。也就是说，他们在学习教育孩子的同时，这些理念他们学到之后，用在企业管理里面。
And then we develop a really, really important lesson for the staff to let them to take care of their family. How can they take care both of work and family and their children? And how can they really spend more time with their family to get a closer relationship with the family members? And then, but at the same time,This training, this course, is also improve the efficiency of the company. Improve the efficiency, let's say, communications, cooperations, something like this.
于是给了我一个机会，就是让我走进了家庭，走进了孩子。当我走进家庭，走进孩子的时候，我想告诉大家，我被震惊了。
And then this is actually giving us a chance that we really come into the.Staff's family, get into their family to know what the relationship now they are having inside the family. So I was stunned by that really serious situation.
孩子内心的那个状态，他们是孤独的、痛苦的，甚至内心是绝望的，甚至是埋怨父母的。既然父母如此的 工作为他们。
Especially their kids, in deep down of their heart, they really complain their parents for busy working, maybe, and really desperate and really feel lonely when they are at home.
我突然发现，这样的孩子长大一定是没有办法去承担他们的责任和企业的责任。
And then I can really understand that this situation when the child grow up, when he become adult, to when he work in the company, these children are going to be no responsible for their work and will be no love for this company at this environment.
而我发现在企业的里面，那些拥有专业的技术，拥有甚至很高的专业学历的人，他们为什么在企业里边不能够发挥他们的最大的价值？很大一个程度是因为他们在家庭的里面所受的影响，这个影响一直延续到他们在工作的里面。
And we also find the high skilled people, the professional people in the company, they have high qualifications, they have really well educated, but what is their really hold them back? It's their family, it's their relationship.Between the staff and his wife or husband, or the relationship between them and the children.
万法皆空，唯因果不变。解决问题是要找到它的根本。
To solve this problem, we cannot just give the usual company training to them. It doesn't solve it at all, because the root of this problem is the family relationship.
企业所出现的问题。如果是假冒伪劣的产品，如果是事故，它是社会问题。
If the company is building a fake product, it's a company an unqualified product, it's a social problem.
如果孩子出现很大的状况，比如说孩子自杀，现在 在我们所了解的状况里边，最近孩子自杀率非常的高。在八年前我说过一句话，我说我们看到了食品污染的危机。看到了环境污染的危机，我们看到了很多的危机，可是有一个更大的危机即将爆发，那个是孩子教育的危机。
Yeah, we also see the suicide rate of China right now for teenagers is really high. Yes, we can see this is a really social problem. That 8 years ago we started to discover this problem of teenagers, but actually now the problem can come out China and everybody can see it.The suicide rate.
而在我们目前我们的状况就是，我们有很多的教育是专业和知识的教育，却没有一个让人内在有能力、有责任感、有使命感、有勇气的这种教育。
And now in China, we have a lot of different kind of skill studies education in school. They all teach teenagers about skills, knowledge, and curriculums, but nothing.To teach their heart, how can they become a responsible person? How can they have a good relationship with their family and the teachers and the classmate friends as well?
我发现这个问题将会是未来的一个很大的社会的问题。
And I can feel that this problem will become a very important social problem later on.
所以我就在想，如何用。教育，因为其实教育企业，让企业业绩增长，这个是一个非常大的挑战，因为你必须要让它增长。可是孩子教育不教育他，好像无所谓，他都在过去。
So actually, we have a lot of method to increase one company's revenue or profit. We have a lot of method to help the company, but we really sometimes ignore the inside problem of our kids.
其实我常常问我的企业家学员哈，我说你们生命中最重要的是什么？他们回答我的问题是最重要的是孩子，可是他们所做的行为是他们并没有花时间花精力在孩子的身上。
I asked the boss man or the entrepreneurs what is the most important for in your life. They always said it's our children, but actually it is just what they said, but not what they do. They do really care. It's about the business.It's about the revenue, the profit of the company.
同时我会发现，其实如果我们这些企业人去教育孩子的话呢，他们其实是有非常多的 智慧，非常多的这种经验，只要把它们用在企业的里面，经验用到家庭里边，家庭一定会很大的改变。
And sometimes we can see that our corporate culture training to the children will be effective at some point of time, that we're really telling our staff the purpose, the goal, our vision about this company, but now we can do this the same way to our children.
所以在企业家的社会责任里面，我们对环境有责任，我们对这个科技哈有这个责任，让社会更进步。那么这些社会变得更好是留给谁的？其实留给孩子的。
And for the social responsibility of our entrepreneurs, we have responsibility to our environment, we have responsibility for our society communities, but also we have social responsibilities for our children of entrepreneurs.
那么我们可不可以直接的有一个社会责任，就是直接的花时间、花精力、花智慧，让我们的孩子可以变得更好。
And can we have a direct social responsibility of entrepreneurs that you should really care about the next generation, really care about our kids?
而这也是社会很大的一个需要。
And this is a big necessary of this society right now in China.
所以我们在去年就有一个想法，就是要做普及的教育，因为社会素质的提升是不是一群人，是整体的人的一个成长。
And from the last year, we really think about how to spread our knowledge, our way of doing to the whole society, that we can like let everybody to listen to our ideas of our methods on our course about how to taking care about children.
其实教育有三个部分，一个是学校的教育，一个是社会的教育，一个是家庭的教育。
And generally, education had three parts, and one is from school, and one is from family, and the other one is from the society.
其实最重要的教育是家庭教育。如果家庭教育失败了，这个孩子几乎没有办法接受学校教育和社会教育。
And the most important education we think that is the family education, or let's say family life or style parenting education. That without education, without that.Family education, the kids cannot really accept the social education or the school education if the family education is not good for them.
如果一个人事业成功了，如果他的孩子学坏了，家庭失败了，他并没有成功。
If one man is really successful in his career, is very successful about inside his company, but if his kids become a gangster or something else, become a bad person in the society, then I don't think that his life is successful.
所以我们成立了线上学院，我们将以最好的教育放在上面，我们呼吁让企业家可以在上面把他们的教育放在上面，用很低很低的价格，就是甚至一天一块钱这样的价格，可能放在上面的知识在我们线下，我们做训练的线下可能是几万甚至几十万的价值，可是我们用一年可能他花几百两三百块钱，他就可以接受这样的教育，来做这样的普及的教育，同时让企业家去承担起这个社会责任，来教育孩子。
And from the last year, we developed the online college that focus on the family life education. That we put our most valuable courses into this online college. That at the same time, we invite all the successful people.From the society that support this college, they can tell their successful family life education stories on the college, on the online college that we can come out to be very influential online platform for everybody in the society.
所以今天我分享的呢，大概就是这样。其实，中国的文化，修身齐家，治国平天下，从个人到家庭，再到社会。
And for the traditional Chinese culture.At the first, we need to amend ourselves, and the second step is to get the whole family together, and then we become the lord of a certain land and become the king of this country. Something like that. It's four steps. Yeah.
而且最近的话呢， 那个习主席哈也讲到家风建设，我觉得这一点是非常的好的，因为社会的最小的细胞是家，当我们的家可以建好的时候，那么社会一定会变好，当我们的企业家也可以投入到家庭教育的时候，那么这个社会会变得更好。
Especially now in the channel at this moment, everybody is talking about the establishment of family style. Even the President Xi at his very important meeting, he speak about to build up a healthy family style is very important for the whole country. It's the key.
好，我的演讲就到这里。
And my speech is over. Thank you very much.
谢谢。